I imagined that there would be words that would come in the painting of the waves, that there would be a kind of music, a kind of wisdom, the finding of deep insights. Instead, there is a silence, absolute, complete, as if I am within the deep, within the womb of the sea, feeling life rush through my veins, allowing the overwhelming power of emotion. Emotions I cannot name, liquid. And I cannot teach you the prayer of the seas and the forests and the mountains, but you who are born of the mountains and the forests and the seas can find their prayers in your heart. It is for me a kind of mystic meditation, watching the ink spread across the paper to reveal a wave. Minuscule spots of ink, some light, some heavy, some lines, some sweeps, a rhythmic play of dark and white. I have worked in silence this weekend, no sound, for there is no one here but me and the prophets of the deep. But even my thoughts are few, and my spirit dips in and out of silence. There is magic in the silver fall, a song of light upon a stream, and laughter in the rippling call of loves and life and leafy dream. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root, and the bud of the bud, and the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than the soul can hope or mind can hold. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart. I am in my tiny studio with the owls and the baobab. I am moved by a nameless emotion, an overwhelming sense of something forgotten, something I should have remembered, a phantom form parting the veil of my mind. At moments feel as if the brush connects me to some sacred inner truth, yet still out of reach. Transient, like the specter of a breath moving the floor. I understand that I could not have been reborn into color if not for the creating of these inkstones. To me, this metaphor of knowing and loving the shadow in order to move into a place of color and light seems quite profound and so indicative of life. Because one cannot truly see light without fully knowing and loving the shadow. In places deep where I have wandered all these small hours, all these dark nights, they feel as if they have given me, as a woman and as a painter, a huge power. It's very hard to explain. It's too great for words. I just have to express them in color, in ink, in pastels, in heart prayers. I am Reyneke, painter. I draw with brushes. And in that drawing, I unlock myself. I give myself thanks. I urge myself. I promise myself to soar.